there in the book of Isaiah, we have a beautiful narrative that Isaiah has given to us as he gives us a picture of the Holy One of Israel and all that God has done for the people of Israel and what he can do for us as his children. Isaiah 61:3, to me, one of the more powerful verses in the Bible. Isaiah writes this. He says, "To appoint unto them that mourn in Zion, to give unto them beauty for ashes." Ashes are, they're nothingness. You know, ashes at one time were, they were a piece of wood, or they were something, but now they're just nothing. Ashes are, they're desolation. Ashes are destruction. When you think of ashes, really, you just think of waste. I don't really know what good you would find in ashes, because ashes are just, they're ash. I mean, they're just a cloud of dirt and dust, and they're just a mess. Really, the truth is, I don't know that anything really comes from ashes. God says, I tell you what, why don't you give me the ashes? When we think about our lives, that isn't that often what we think of? We think of ash. You know, maybe in our lives, we have sorrow. We lost a loved one, and we have sorrow. Or maybe in our lives, we have shame. We have regret. We have things that are dirty to us, and the ashes that were in our lives continue to grow. The ashes that are in our lives, and when we look at our lives, we say, God, I don't understand why you'd want my ashes. But God says, no, that's exactly what I want. I want your ashes. I want you to give me what you think is the worst part of you. What you think that no one else could use. See, when you go to the devil, you know the devil doesn't really want your ashes. When the prodigal son, if he would have just had ashes, can you imagine how many friends he would have had? He wouldn't have had many friends. He said, hey, bring me, you know, you got the money. You got the party. You've got all those things. And hey, I can do something if you'll give me all those things. But God says, no. You can keep all those things. All I want are your ashes. And the more that we give him our ashes to us, the more we lose the beauty. To us, the more that we don't see ash, we just see dust. I mean, ashes will cause all kinds of problems. It makes me filthy. He said, God, why would you want filthiness? God, why would you want all these things? I don't know, God, why you would want all of my ashes. And God says, you know what? No, that's exactly what I want. I want you to give me your ashes. And see, what to us is ash, and what to us is destruction, and what to us are all these things that we would never want to do anything with, because they're just waste. They're just nothingness. God says, if you will give me your ashes, if you will give me the things that nobody wants in your life, if you'll give me all of those things, the devil doesn't want them, your friends don't want them, he says, I can give you my beauty for your ashes. He says, hey, I'll give you the cross. God says, you throw all those things at me, and I'm going to hang on Calvary, and every sin of all mankind is going to be thrown on me. And what that day looked like many people as the end, what that day looked to many people as a bad deal, God looked down from heaven, and we saw ashes, but what he saw is he saw beauty. And that day as he hung, as the Son of God hung on Calvary, he understood you, and he understood me. And there was collateral beauty in all of those things as God, Jesus Christ, dirtied his hands with the sins of mankind. And what you're going through right now, he knew about it. And it wasn't a surprise to him. And he says, give me all of the dirty parts of you. Trade all of those things in, and I'll give you my beauty. And there on the cross that day, he hung and he died and he bled. But we know the victory came on the third day when he rose from the grave. There's times of grief we go through. There's trouble with God that we may have in our lives. But may I challenge you tonight, allow God to make you a trophy of grace. Look for the collateral beauty.